Alright guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video I'm going to show you how to bleed the cooling system on your B58. Now the B58 cooling system can be a little bit intimidating if you don't know what you're looking at, but if you've done the bleed procedure on previous BMW models, it's a very similar process. The only difference is, instead of having one electric pump that requires going through, you know, the pedal process inside of the car to activate it, we now have two completely separate cooling systems. And we actually have three water pumps, two electric and one mechanical. So I'm going to walk you through the process to bleed everything. But before we go too far, I do want to give a big thank you to all of the channel sponsors. Their links and contact information is listed down below in the description. If you're looking to modify your B58 and add some power modifications or exterior modifications, or just get some dyno time, please check out the guys that I have linked down below. They support the channel, and the more that you support them, the more that we can make videos testing out different parts and different things like that. So again, a big thank you to them, and a thank you to you guys for everybody that's supported so far. Now let's get into the meat of the video. So like I said, we have two completely separate cooling systems, and you can fill them up individually with these two tanks in your engine bay. This small tank is a part of your low temperature cooling system, and it primarily works with your intercooler to make sure that you're keeping the IATs down and cooling off the air that's coming out of your turbo. It's separated from the rest of your cooling system because you want those temps to be as low as possible. So they separate it from the other engine components that get a lot hotter so that you can have your intercooler work as efficiently as possible. So your low temperature circuit will need to be bled if you replace anything that's tied into that circuit. So that includes your intake manifold with the integrated intercooler, or if you replaced the main heat exchanger that's at the front of the car, if you replaced your water pump that's down here next to the headlight, or any of the cooling hoses that go throughout that circuit. If you replaced anything that's connected to your low temperature cooling circuit that would require draining it, you're going to need to do the bleed process for your low temp circuit. Now this one only has one electric pump, so it's actually pretty simple. So in order to do that, the first thing you need to do is obviously top off your system. If you have the BMW tool to vacuum fill, that's great, but I know a lot of people don't have an air supply where they're working. So that's something that I typically skip just because most people don't have the tools. It's nice because it actually puts a vacuum on the circuit and pulls coolant into everything to try to evacuate as much air as possible, but you can always do the manual process to get pretty much the same effect. Now, once you've topped it off, I recommend squeezing some of the hoses to try to manually get some air out. So I usually just reach down here and squeeze this line, and it'll start creating bubbles and you'll actually hear it sucking coolant in. Again, just keep doing that until you get it filled up as much as possible. And then we're going to do the process inside of the car to manually activate the electronic water pump. So when you get in the driver's seat, what you're going to do is turn on the car, just put on the battery, don't actually turn on the engine. And then you're going to turn on your headlights, don't leave it in automatic. And then you're going to turn your heat to the highest setting and then turn it to the lowest fan speed. It needs to be in manual mode, so turn off auto. And then you're going to turn on your hazards. And after you've done that, you hold down the accelerator pedal for about 15 seconds. And you'll begin to hear kind of a small buzzing sound, and that's your water pump running. And if you actually go and look inside of your coolant tank, you'll begin seeing coolant move around a little bit, and that's the water pump running. Now this process will run for about 10 minutes. You might need to do it a couple times to completely bleed the system, but just keep an eye on your coolant levels and keep topping it off to keep it between the minimum and maximum line. I've had to do it about two or three times whenever I did a job like replacing my heat exchanger to completely bleed the system. Now this larger reservoir is a part of your high temp cooling circuit, and that basically supplies coolant to everything else. So that means your engine block, your turbo, you have two auxiliary heat exchangers down here on the sides, and you also have one additional main radiator that's sandwiched behind the radiator for your intercooler. All of the hoses and everything that's related to your main cooling system is all pulling coolant from that large reservoir. So if you replaced anything that required draining that reservoir, then you're going to need to do the bleed process for your high temp circuit. Now this is the circuit that has two different pumps. It has one mechanical pump that's on the front of your engine block, and also an electrical pump that's towards the back of the engine. So you're going to need to do a bleed process for both of those pumps in order to fully bleed the system. Again, you can begin by filling it up, and if you have the BMW tool to vacuum fill it, that's a great option to try to fill it up more quickly. If you don't have the tool or you don't have an air supply, again, you can manually squeeze hoses, like this one is a part of your main intercooler circuit. So I'll squeeze this hose a couple times to try to actually get most of the air out of the system and suck some more coolant back into it. And after you've done that, we're going to go back into the car to do the process where you manually turn on your electric water pump. So again, you sit down in the driver's seat, make sure you put your seatbelt on, and then you're going to hit the start stop button 3 times quickly. And then you're going to go and again, put your fan on the highest temperature with the lowest fan speed. Don't let it stay in auto, it needs to be in manual mode. And then hold down the accelerator pedal for 15 seconds. And after that, again, you'll hear a whirring sound, and that way you'll know that your water pump has turned on. And if you go and look into the main reservoir, sometimes it's a little hard to see, but you will see the coolant flowing, and that means that your electric water pump is pumping. Now, after you've done that, you've turned on your electric water pump, but you still need to activate your mechanical water pump to fully bleed the system. So to do that, you're going to turn on the car, and you'll actually see with the electric pump running, the car will automatically know that you're doing the bleed process. So it'll keep your revs up to about 1200 RPM, almost like a cold start, but it's just gonna hold it up there, indicating that you've turned on the procedure to bleed your cooling system. At this point, you're going to rev your engine. And so it recommends revving up to like 3000 RPM. Usually I only do like 2000 to 2500 just so I don't annoy my neighbors. But basically the higher you rev the engine, the faster the pump will flow. So the better job it'll do of bleeding your cooling system. But keep in mind, if your engine is cold, you don't necessarily want to go crazy revving it really high. So rev the engine for about 10 seconds and then let it go back to idle for about 30 seconds. And then again, rev the engine for 10 seconds and let it go back to idle for 30 seconds. You do that about 10 times and that cycles coolant through the mechanical water pump and gets more air out of the system. Just like for the low temp circuit, you might need to do this 2 or 3 times to completely bleed the system, but at that point, you're done. Once you've noticed that the coolant levels are no longer dropping, it's a good time to put the cap back on your reservoirs and take your car for a drive. I usually just let the car get up to temperature, maybe go for like a 10 to 15 minute drive, nothing crazy. Then I get back home, let the car cool down, and take the reservoir caps off again just to check my cooling levels. The more you drive the car, the more it'll bleed the cooling system and just put the car under different scenarios so that you can fully get all of the air out of the system. So maybe for like the next 2 days, just keep an eye on it as you drive the car, top off the coolant as needed, and then at that point you'll be done. So that's how you bleed the cooling system on your B58 and kind of a little walkthrough on how the cooling system works. Hopefully this video helps. And if you guys have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Thanks. Do do do.